Hello everybody and welcome back to another part in our character creation videos. Today we are going to look at adding different animations for different weapons, so we can have a different animation when we are holding a pistol, or when we are holding a rifle, or when we are unarmed for example. And we are going to use an enumeration for that. So let's get started right away. We're going to go to the characters folder, at least that's where I'm going to put it, and I'm going to create a new enumeration. So right click and go to blueprints enumeration. I'm going to call this weapon NMs underscore enum, and I'm going to open this. Open it in the right window, please. Thank you. So I'm going to click the new button over here, that's going to create a new enum, and I'm going to call this unarmed. Unarmed, yeah. And I'm going to click the new button again, and I'm going to call the next enum pistol. And the last one we're going to create right now is the rifle, like so. We're going to save and close this down. And now we are going to go to our character blueprint, so open the base character. And we are going to create this new variable in here as well, so click the new variable, and we're going to call this animSet. For the variable type, click this and look for weapon anims, and we can select the anims enumeration we just created. So the weapon anims enum, select that. I'm going to put this in the player variables category, like so. I'm going to compile this and set the default value to rifle. And that's all we have to do in here right now. So let's save and close this down. And we need another aim offset for our new weapon, so we're going to create that first. Go to our aim offsets folder and duplicate the one we already have. And I'm going to call this Murdoch pistol aim offset and open this up. Now we already have this set up to use the pitch, minus 90 to 90, and I'm simply going to replace the animations. So I'm going to look for aim offset animations. And the pistol is also the spread shot, so I'm going to use these ones. Spread shot center, center, I'm going to drop to pitch 0. Center down is going to pitch minus 90. And center up is going to pitch 90. Now if I change my preview animation over here, so look for the shotgun loop. Now you can see we have an aim offset for our pistol working. So we're going to save and close this down, so we can use it later. And we go in to go to our animation blueprint and go to make some changes in here. So open the anim blueprint, and the first thing we're going to do is add the variable in here as well. So click the new variable, call this one the weapon anim set, and we're going to set this type to the weapon anims enumeration we created, so weapon anims enum. And again we're going to set the default to rifle, so compile this and set default to rifle, like this. And at this point we need to go to the anim graph and make some changes in here, so go to the anim graph, I was already there. First thing, we go to our base locomotion and open the idle state in here. Now if we disconnect the play idle and we drag off this and look for our weapons anim, we see a note in here, blend poses weapon anims enumeration. So that's the enum we created. We can select this right now. And if we right click on this note, we can add pins for the enums. So we are going to add the pistol pin and the rifle pin at this moment. For the default pose and the rifle pose, we are going to use the rifle animation, so that's the play idle, just copy and paste it like this. For the pistol pose, we are going to use the shotgun loop, so the shotgun is also the pistol for Murdoch, that's a bit confusing, but that's the way it is. So the pistol pose is the shotgun loop, and we are going to plug in the weapon anim sets enumeration onto this pin. Connect this to the final animation pose and we are done, so that should work. Go back to the base locomotion and open the walk run sprint. And again, we are going to add our blend by enumeration. So disconnect this pin, drag over here and do blend weapon anims. And select the weapon anims enumeration. Add the pins we need for the pistol and the rifle pose. Connect it to the final pose. Copy this, paste this, and plug it in the rifle pose. Now make a little bit of room over here. Let's make sure we connect up the weapon anim set so we don't forget this one. And copy and paste this again. Now I'm going to go back to the animation grab and I'm going to grab this layered blend per bone node. Simply because we already entered these values over here, so we already got everything. So copy this one and I'm going to go back to the base locomotion walk run sprint and paste in the blend pose. Plug in this one to the base pose and plug the shotgun loop into the blend pose, like so. This is going to be our pistol pose and that's connected up as well, so that's fine. So that should do it for this. Let's go back over here to our animation graph and over here we also want to add the blend node, so we're going to move over this from the aim offset. Disconnect the aim offset to the blend per bool and over here we're going to look for the blend for the enumeration, so blend weapon anims enum. We are going to plug this one into the false pose from the bool. Make sure we connect up our weapon anim sets enumeration over here and add the pins we need for the pistol and the rifle. So we can simply copy and paste this default pose and use it for the rifle pose. Just plug it in like this. And now I'm going to copy the one of the state machines, the upper body slot, the layered blend and the pitch. And I'm going to paste this down below here for the pistol pose. Now I'm going to use the new aim offset we just created, so look for that in the asset browser, the Murdoch pistol aim offset. Plug that into the base pose and connect up the pitch. Connect this one to the pistol pose over here. And now all we need to do is change the jump locomotion states. Now because we already have the blend by enum over here, we can simply replace the animations with the shotgun ones. But we need the blend node, so I'm going to go back and copy the layered blend per bone node. And I'm going to go into the state machine for jumping for the pistol. Go to the jumps, jumping state machine, the jump start, and paste in the layered blend per bone. The base pose is the jump start. Look for the shotgun loop and plug it into the blend pose. Plug it into the final pose and I'm going to copy the loop and the blend node. Go back, go to the jump apex and do the same thing. So disconnect this, paste the layered blend per bone and connect them up again. Go back once more to the jump pre-land, disconnect this, paste in the layered blend and connect the final pose again. So we're done for this state machine. Let's go back to the jump land and disconnect the additive animation over here. And this time we simply want to blend by the enum. So we're going to do blend weapon anims enum. Plug this into the additive animation. Make sure we connect the anim sets enumeration over here. Add the pins we need for the pistol and the rifle pose. Copy the rifle pose and the default pose so they are the same. And we're going to look for the jump additive for the spread shot, which is the shotgun. So spread shot. Now there's a typo in here. It's spelled with a T, so if you look for spread you won't find it. So spread shot jump land additive. and that's going to be our pistol additive. Plug it in like so, and we are done for this state machine as well. Now we are going to simply copy and paste this state machine and plug it into the base pose as well. So that should do it for the new animation blueprint. And we have now added our pistol animations in here. Let me scroll down in my notes real quick to see what we can do next. We need to make sure we populate the weapon anim set variable. So go to the event graph and we're going to drag off the base character node. So as the base character, drag off this, look for an empty spot, and we're going to say get anim set. If I can still spell words, get anim set. We're going to drag in a setter for the weapon anim set over here, connect this, and make sure we connect it to the last of our execution pins. And let's put a quick comment around this, set anim set enum. So that should work as well right now. And we are done for the animation blueprint at this point, so let's compile and save this and close it down. Now we're going to need to create a few animations. I'm going to go to the Paragon folders, characters, hero, Murdoch, animations. Now this weapon doesn't have a raise and a lower animation, it only has a raise animation and it fires and then immediately holsters the weapon. I don't know if they forgot to put in animations or that's just the way the weapon works in this game and you can only fire it once and it holsters automatically. But that's not the way I want it to work, so I'm going to create a few quick animations. This is not going to look perfect, but it's just for the sake of showing you how it could work if you have a raise and a lower animation. So you can raise the weapon, lower the weapon, and then raise a new weapon, etc. So that's the quick why we are doing this. Look for the shotgun animations, and you can see the shotgun fire holster, the shotgun loop, and the shotgun start. The shotgun start, we're just going to use it as it is. We're going to duplicate the fire holster animation and call this shotgun fire. Open this up. And we're going to remove all the frames after frame 11, so let's drag it right around here and right click. It says remove from frame 12 to frame 34. Click that and it simply deletes all those frames. That's fine, so we're going to save and close this down. We're going to duplicate this again, so the fire holster animation, press Ctrl W and name this one shotgun holster. Open this up and we're going to remove the first 6 frames from here, so let's drag it right around here somewhere, right click on the little dragger, remove frame 0 to 7, that's a little bit too much, drag it a bit more to the left, remove frame 0 to 6, like so. So now we have a kind of holster animation and a kind of fire animation, so save and close this down. We need to create montages for these animations, so the shotgun fire, right click, create, create anim montage, open it up and set the default slot to the upper body slot, save and close this down, and do the same for the shotgun holster and the shotgun start animation, so create, create anim montage, open it up and change the default group to the upper body slot. And last thing, the shotgun start animation, create anim montage and change the anim slot to the upper body slot. Save and close this down as well. So now we have 3 animations, the fire, the holster, the raise, and we already had a looping animation, so that's fine. We have something to work with now. Let me scroll down my notes again a little bit. At this point, we are going to go back to our character folders. Let's remove the filter over here and we are going to open the weapon info structure. And again, we're going to add a variable in here. So click the new variable. And we're going to call this weapon anim set. And this is going to be the type of the enumeration we created. So weapon anims enum. Select this one. And you can set a default value if you like. I'm going to set it to rifle just for now. Save and close this down. And open the weapon info table. In the weapon info table, the secondary weapon is the spreadshot, and I'm going to use this one as the pistol. So I'm going to select the spreadshot weapon, scroll down over here, and for the weapon anim set, I'm going to set it to pistol. At this point, I'm also going to change the fire animation. So the fire anim is going to be our shotgun fire montage. And I'm also going to change the muzzle socket. Muzzle socket is now muzzle 01 and it's going to be muzzle 03, like so. Let's save and close this down. So you can simply get the sockets from the skeleton. If you open the character and go to your skeleton, the skeleton tree, and you can play an animation and you can check out what socket belongs to what weapon, basically. So if I look for the shotgun loop, you can see it playing the animation, and if I select the bones or the sockets over here, you can automatically see which one belongs to which weapon. So that's how you get the correct sockets. Just a little note over there. Okay, let's close this down. So we added things to our data table, and now we are going to open the character blueprint. So go to the base character. Again, we need to add another variable. This one is going to be for the weapon variables. So add a new variable, the current weapon anim set, so CW anim set. Again, this is going to be the type of the weapon anims enum we created. So set it to weapon anims enum. And we need to make sure this replicates. So replication, set this to replicated. And I forgot to set the replication for the anim set enum on the player variable, so do that as well. Go to the one we created at the start of this video, the anim set enumeration on the player, and also make sure this is set to replicated, like so. Next, we're going to go to our set active weapon variables, and we're going to add the new current weapon anim set, so not the player variable, but the CW anim set. Let me put it in the right category over here, weapon variables. Okay, drag in the setter and connect it up to the output pins and to the other setters, like this. And we need to do the same thing in the server set active weapon variables. So go to the server set active weapon variables and again drag in the CW anim set. Connect it up to the other setters and connect up the enumeration like this. So we have that set up. And now we're going to create a bunch of custom events. So let's close down these functions we don't need like this and go to an empty spot on our event graph. First, I'm going to create a custom event, and the first custom event is going to be called set rifle enemies. And I'm going to create another custom event, and that's going to be called server set rifle enims. And for the server set rifle enims, we want to make this replicated to run on server and set it to reliable. From the server set rifle enims, drag off and call the set rifle enims event like this. And for the set rifle enims, drag off and check if we have authority. If we are a client, we're going to call the server set rifle enims. So this one. And after that, we are going to set the anim set enumeration for the player. We don't ever want to change the anim set for the current weapon because that comes from the weapon and we need to store this on the player. So the one we are going to change is the player variable. Look for the anim set, drag in a setter, connect up both of the execution pins and set it to the rifle enum like this. So that's the set rifle animations part, and we are going to go and do the same thing for the unarmed animations. So we're going to right click and create a custom event, call this set unarmed anims, and create another custom event and call this server set unarmed anims. Again, make the server set unarmed anims replicated to run on server, make it reliable, and just make this one call the set unarmed anims function. From the set unarmed anims function, we're going to drag off and check if we have authority. If we are a client, we are going to call the server set unarmed anims. And after that, we are simply going to set the anim set enumeration to our unarmed state and connect both of the execution pins just like we did in previous function or event or however you want to call it. So that's that. And the last we are going to create is for the pistol. So we're going to create a few custom events again. Custom event. And let's call this set pistol anims. Create another custom event. Call it server set pistol anims. And for this one, we are going to create a third one as well. So create custom event and call this MC set pistol anims. So we're going to use another multicast in here. So make sure this is set to replicate as multicast and it's reliable. And for the server set pistol anims, set it to run on server and be reliable as well. Now the reason we are also using a multicast is because we want to play the raise and lower animation, so we actually want to see other clients what we do as well when we play the animations. Because we don't have a raise and a lower animation for the rifle and the unarmed state, we can simply change the state and it will blend into the new poses. So we need to play animations, and because we want all clients to see it and not just the server and myself, we need a multicast event. So that's why we have three over here. So from the server set pistol anims, we are going to drag off and call the multicast pistol anims. From the set pistol anims, we're going to drag off and check if we have authority. If we have authority, we are going to call our multicast set pistol anims. And if we are a client, we are going to call the server set pistol anims. Like this. And let me double check for the multicast. We want to play the animation, but we are also going to add a boolean in here, so let me do that first. In all three of these functions, we are going to create an input and we're going to call this raise, and it's a boolean, so this tells us if we are raising or lowering the weapon. If it's true, we're raising. If it's false, we are lowering the weapon. So do it for all three of these functions: raise a boolean and input raise and boolean. Connect up the pins, make sure you don't forget, so just do it right away like this. And the first thing we want to add in our multicast is a branch to check if we are raising or lowering, so plug it in like this. If it's true, we want to play our anim montage and we want to play the raise animation, so select the shotgun start montage. Copy and paste this, and for the false, we want to play the shotgun holster animation, so shotgun holster montage. Drag off this and add a small delay node. Let's keep the delay at 0.2, that's fine. Plug in the other one as well, and right after this, we simply want to set our anim set again, so copy and paste the anim set, connect it up to the delay node and set this to our pistol. That should do. Let's drop in our current weapon anim set just like this, so that should work fine as well. So now we have our switch weapon events. This may not be the most elegant way to do this, but because I only have raise and lower animations for the pistol and this just works slightly different, I decided to go for this. If you have raise and lower animations for all of your weapons, you can simply make a raise and lower animation. So first you lower your active weapon, then you raise the new weapon, so etc. I think you should be able to figure that out, possibly. I'm going to keep it like this for now. So we are done over here and we need to go to the cycle weapon events. So look for the cycle weapon stuff we added previously, the cycle weapons up and down. After this, I'm going to create two new custom events. So create a custom event and I'm going to call this update anims. Anim set, let's call it update anim set. That should work. And create another custom event and call this server update anim set. The server update anim set is replicated to run on the server. It's reliable and we want to call the update anim set from here like this. Excuse me. Now for this new event, the update anim set, let me check my notes real quick. We want to check if we have authority first, so drag off this and type have authority. Switch has authority. If we have authority, we are going to continue with another branch, so let's edit right here. If we are not authority, we are going to call the server update anims. Server update anim set. And we continue with the branch as well. So connect these up like this. For the branch, we want to check if our current weapon anim set is not the same as our player anim set. So drag in the current weapon anim set. We get a getter, drag off this and type not equal. And we want to know if it's not equal to our player's anim set. So drag in the anim set from the player variables and drag this onto our condition. Now, if this is false, we are not going to do anything because we already have the correct anim set. And if it's true, we are going to switch on our enumeration. So look for switch on weapons anim enumeration. So here's the enum we created previously and we can use it again. Here you see our unarmed pistol and rifle pins we added. So we can simply drag in our CW anim set and plug it into our input pin over here. And we can decide what we want to do for what enumeration. So first for the pistol one, for the unarmed one, I'm going to add a branch. And I'm going to check if my current anim set, so the player anim set, drag that in while holding control. If that's pistol, so hold equal or type equal and select pistol over here. So if my current anim set is pistol, I want to play the lower animation. So from the true pin, I'm going to drag off and say set pistol anims. Call the set pistol anims event and make sure the raise is set false. So I'm not raising, but I'm lowering my pistol. And after that, I want to add a small delay. So drag off here and do delay. Let's make this 0.4. So I have a little bit of time to play the holster animation before I start blending to my unarmed pose. So something like 0.4, you can mess around with that. And after that, I'm going to call my set unarmed anims event just like this. And from the false pin, I'm simply going to call the set unarmed enems event directly. So copy and paste and connect it to the false pin over here. And that should do it for the unarmed pin over here. For the pistol, I'm simply going to copy the set pistol enems node. I'm going to set the boolean to true, so I'm raising my pistol and I'm plugging it into the pistol pin over here. And for the last one, I'm going to add a branch again, and again I want to know if my current anim set is pistol, so I'm going to copy this part, copy and paste it over here, connect the branch up to the rifle. If my current weapon is pistol, I want to play the lower animation first, so I'm going to call the set pistol anims false. And if I'm lowering my pistol, I will automatically go to the rifle pose, because that's the default pose for this character basically, or the way I set it up at least. So I simply lower my pistol and I'm going to end up in my rifle pose, so that should do. And for the false, I'm going to call the set rifle anim set event, like so. So if I'm not wielding a pistol, I don't need to play the holster animation, I can simply change the enumeration, and I'm going to use the event we created for that. So I'm sure it replicates and stuff like that. So that should work over here. Now we need to go to the end of both of our cycle weapon events, so the cycle weapon up and the cycle weapon down event. Go all the way to the last node, the set active weapon variables, and from that we are going to call the update anim set. And do that for both of the events, like so. And now we should have a working pistol animation pose. We don't actually have an unarmed animation pose yet, but we already added the enum for it, so we can simply add it in the next video, but I think I'm going to leave it right here. First, we're going to check if this is working. So let me play this. I'm starting with my rifle pose because that's the default pose, and if I switch to my pistol, you can see I'm playing the raise animation, and now I'm using the pistol idle pose. The jumping is working. I have an aim offset for my pistol. I'm using a different muzzle. I'm using a different fire animation. I can holster it again. So everything seems to be working pretty nice over here. Let me see if this is working. Oh, what's this? We have an error.